You know, the emotional and physical tolls of caregiving are profound. Studies show caregivers who experience chronic stress may be at a greater risk of experiencing their own cognitive and physical decline. To help caregivers take care of themselves and our own well-being, AARP Washington, BECU, and King 5 are inviting you to a free event tonight with NBC News journalist Richard Lui. And we are lucky enough to have Richard on the couch with us this morning to share your connection to this cause. Now, let's talk about your personal connection to caregiving, your father. What was happening in your life when you found out your father needed you?
Well, like you, I was news anchoring, being a journalist. And it was very common that I would be asked also to fly to different breaking news stories across the country or in Europe. And so when I got the call from my dad that he said I got diagnosed, and it's confirmed, I have Alzheimer's. And I immediately was thinking two things. One, our job's not part-time, so I would have to give up something that I worked
for. Knew that you were going to have to quit your job.
Yeah, because there's no such thing as a... So I went to my boss, Yvette Miley, I sat down. I had already written the note that I thank you for giving me a great job. I'm sorry I have to leave, because I knew she was probably going to say, we love you. When you're done, come on back. And instead she said, let's figure this out. And so then began now my seventh or eighth year working the days that I can and then flying back to California from New York to take care of my dad for 7 years.
You did this for seven years?
7 years, and now my mother, who also has been diagnosed with dementia.
I'm sorry to hear that. How did you keep yourself sane? I mean, that is a toll.
You know, I think that journalists are kind of built for that. So the first 5 years, the crazy schedule of travel and no sleep, I was fine with. The sixth year, I was standing in the subway in New York at 3 a.m., and I was the only person, and it was cold and windy. I did stop and think, what am I doing?
What am I doing with my life? Well, you've done a lot with your life since, and you've made a new movie, Unconditional. Please tell us about that.
So Unconditional was something that started to show the idea of mental health and caregiving, and to try to show the shades of gray that we go through as caregivers and the mental health challenges we have. It's very important to say there's 100 million people in America annually that go through a mental health challenge. Half of them are probably caregivers. And that mental health is not a one or zero, and mental health is not mental illness. Those are very important ideas.
People don't understand these things. We're just kind of learning as a society the difference between them and the important difference. Your movie is raw, it's straightforward and so honest. I mean, that is the journalist in you, obviously, but why was it important to show those parts?
You know, it's imperfect the way we love people. And that the way we show care. And like me caring for my dad was very imperfect. There were times that I was with him and we could go through things and I'd smile and I'd laugh. I learned how to cry differently and laugh differently throughout that entire process. And I didn't know that along the way, nor did I know that I would be saying the words mental health and me out loud so commonly. And it's just like with physical health, why aren't we talking about mental health similarly? I gained 10 pounds during COVID. I also got 5 pounds on my brain. So I got to work it off, And we also have to think about mental health as a potential muscle, as a strength,
because
not as a weakness.
We need to be resilient.
We are. We are.
I have to ask, you know, I was sharing with you that caregiving doesn't always come later in life.
Like
you said, you're in the middle of your career. I was in the middle of mine. I had just had a baby and I had to instantly become a caregiver for my mom. And it was really scary.
And you felt alone.
And I felt alone. I felt so alone and I didn't know who to turn to. But it's not just the caregiver who's young. I think a lot of people that can flip the other way. People who are a young age, like Luke and his wife Amy in your film about their life and how they are at a young age dealing with this.
Luke and Amy Bouchatz in Alaska drove across the country to find a space where caregiving would work well for Luke, who was the veteran, is the veteran, and now continues to serve. What's amazing about their journey together is that Amy was there by his side and he by her side to understand the stresses that they were both going through. He through PTSD and TBI, she going through as a caregiver and trying to understand what was happening. You talked about age group. It is assumed that people my age struggling with it. Yes, it is that. Mm-hmm. But 50%, just about.
50%.
50%, and there's 53 million who are caregivers, family caregivers, untrained, unpaid across our great country. Half of them are millennial or younger. Half. 25 million. One more. 17 and younger. 5 million.
Okay, I have the chills right now, Richard.
In other words, we feel like we're alone all along the age spectrum.
Yeah.
You, as a young caregiver, you were part of the majority or a good portion of 50%.
I know we're about out of time, but I want to ask you one more thing because you say this is not a ho-hum subject.
Yeah.
I know you just cited those statistics that kind of prove your point, but what do you mean?
You know, what I learned doing 7 years of filming these families is that, yes, it is a ho-hum topic, but it's also a ha-ha topic.
Mm.
As you remember, you found new capabilities in yourself and in your mother about how you would laugh together and enjoy life together.
Absolutely.
And just the way we celebrate and we gather for when we arrive, we should do the same as we leave.
Hmm.
Because I learned that caring for my father, that I was laughing in ways, Amity, that I had never laughed before.
Yeah.
And I was so glad that I was there along the way. I want to be very clear. Mm-hmm. I'm not the best human around. But after that,
are any of us? Are any of us?
But at the end of this, I would say I am the best human I've ever been.
Amen. Thank you so much. And you all, you can hear more from Richard at this evening's Caring for Caregiver event at Town Hall Seattle. Richard will be joined by Dr. Kate Zong, geriatric psychiatrist and founder of the Brainovation Initiative at UNLV. She'll be providing tips and tools for boosting brain health. The event, hosted by evening's Jim Dever, starts at 7:30. Doors open at 6. It's all free, but they're asking for you to pre-register online or by calling the number on your screen.
This portion of New Day Northwest is sponsored by AARP and BECU.